Folks, welcome back. I have your latest home prices and insights for week ending June the 30th. This report is for the City of Toronto, just for the City of Toronto. Every Tuesday you come back, you see this report, but I cover all the GTA. And on Wednesdays, I do a Peel and Durham report. On Thursdays, I cover York Region. And on Saturdays, I do a luxury report, any property listed or sold at $3 million or more. So I'm officially declaring this is your one-stop shop for all your GTA real estate needs. I got to ask, as I go through these numbers shortly, I'm asking over and over again, have we reached the peak? Did we miss the peak? Is the top end of the market behind us already? You know, each week I get a bunch of calls from those of you that watch me on YouTube talking to me about your own personal real estate situations. I love the calls. Sometimes you call, I could be with a client or I could be in a meeting, and it's tough to take the call. So to make it better for you, more convenient, we've put a link to a calendar in the description below. Click the link to the calendar if you want to talk to me. Schedule a time that works for you, and I will make sure I'm available. The way I see it, if you're gonna take the time to reach out to me, I wanna make sure I'm giving you the time you deserve. Before I get into the numbers, please hit the subscribe button, hit the bell button, comment below, share the video. The reason I'm asking you to do this now, because I know there's gonna be a bunch of you that don't like these numbers I'm about to share with you right now, but let's get right into it. Okay, so I've got City of Toronto only on the board here, broken down on a weekly basis. Now, sales are at 249. This is just for detached properties across the City of Toronto. 249 is up from the previous week, and it's been a while since I've said sales are up from the previous week. Overall, they're down almost on a weekly basis from kind of where we peaked mid-March, but they're up from the previous week of 249. The amount of properties sold at $2 million or more is down to 49 from 53 the previous week. And average sold price, barely unchanged. It's up by a little less than $700. It's now sitting at $1,637,000. So we were way up here over $1.8 million, over $1.7 million. And we're kind of going up and down, up and down. I'm thinking we might have missed the peak already. This is all the City of Toronto, average sold price of 1.637. If we break it down, Toronto in three sections, we got the West, the East, and the Central. In the East, the average sold price is sitting at $1,287,000. In the West, it's up by about $200,000 from there to $1,488,000. And in the Central, it's up by about $1 million from there to $2,404,000. It's a completely different prices, different everything when it comes to the three different areas of Toronto there. But back to Toronto as a whole, just the City of Toronto, when we compare this year's average sold price to last year's average sold price for the same week, week ending June 30th, we're actually down by 1% average sold price. Now, last year at this time, we sold 61 properties at $2 million or more. This year, we sold 49. So as a whole, the City of Toronto, we were doing better last year at this time than this year. When we kind of take a look at the sales, the 249 that we sold is actually less than what we sold last year at this time. Now, sales, the blue is last year's sales. So the blue, we can see we were coming out of our first stay-at-home orders, and we were getting kind of more comfortable with this whole health crisis. I shouldn't say comfortable, but kind of knowing a little bit more of what to expect. We stopped hoarding toilet paper here and started buying houses, and you could see sales, the blue, going up. This year, we started high, and sales generally have been coming down week after week, And of the 249, 59% sold at list price or more. Last year at this time, it was 54%. So very, very close, very similar there. Looking at listings, same thing when it comes to listings. If we're looking at just the blue is last year's, we're going up, heading into where we are now, June 30th. But this year we started high and listings have been coming down. We listed only 306 detached properties in all of the city of Toronto last week. And months of inventory is sitting at 1.1. So it did come down. The market did get a little bit tighter. The low number, although sales are lower, we also had fewer listings come on the market, which is really weird to you know, there's been so much talk about while we're having these stay-at-home orders that sellers don't want to put their properties on the market. They don't want strangers walking through their house. They're waiting for things to open up to put their properties on the market. Well, we're there. Things are opening up. Where are all the listings? Or maybe it's normal. This is a seasonal thing. And at this time, listings and sales and average sold, everything kind of calms down a little bit at this time of the year. Maybe it's a bit of that. Nobody knows for sure. I know there's lots of people that'll tell you exactly what it is, but I'm telling you from my own personal experience of being in the field, being a full-time realtor, working with buyers and sellers, I'm getting all sorts of different attitudes out there that, you know, kind of sometimes contradict each other. But this is Toronto as a whole. Let's break down months of inventory in the three different sections. So we've got the West. We sold 83. 71% sold at list price or more. So Toronto as a whole, I said 59%. This here, the West, is 71% sold at list price or more. So it's very competitive in the West. And average sold price is 7% higher than what it was last year. Toronto as a whole, it's 1% lower. The West is 7% higher. Now, West being from basically everything west of Dufferin, so Etobicoke and Rexdale area. When we look at Central, 43% are being sold at list price or more. So a lot less competitive in the Central. And the Central is where we have most of our a big percentage of sales is the luxury market. Average sold price is 5% lower than what it was this time last year. So the West, 7% higher. Central, 5% lower. And the East, which is basically Victoria Park, O'Connor, Don Valley. So we're looking at East York, Beaches, Scarborough. That's the east side, according to the Toronto Real Estate Board. Well, we're at 59% of those sales being sold at list price or more, but we're 11% higher than last year's average sold price. So the East is outperforming all of Toronto, or the different parts of Toronto. It's doing the best as far as percentage increase over last year's average sold price. And it'll be a different buying or selling experience in each of those sections. And then you start talking about all the different neighborhoods. I've only broken it down on this show in three sections. But when I'm talking to my seller clients or when I'm talking to my buyer clients, I'm breaking it down just within the few streets around their neighborhood. And from one block to another, one neighborhood to another, it could be vastly different. There's neighborhoods that are down 15% from where they were last year's price, and there's neighborhoods up 30% from last year's average sold price. This is why I say it's so important to be working with a knowledgeable, strong realtor that's going to have your best interests at heart, not somebody that just picks their numbers out from the news. Okay, so looking at semis. Months of inventory sitting at 0.9, very much still a seller's market when it comes to semis. 79% sold at list price or more. The average semi price did go up to a little bit over 1.3 million, and that is 7% higher than last year's average sold price. Townhouses, months of inventory came down to 1.1, still very much a seller's market. That's just a given for anything we're talking about when it comes to GTA real estate right now. It's a seller's market. We only sold 27 townhouses on all the city of Toronto. Average sold price did come down. It kind of normalized. The 1.2 mil you know, you could look at it and say, wow, it came down quite a bit. But the previous week of the almost 1.4 million, two semis were sold at $2 million and one semi was sold for $4.4 million. That just shot the average sold price up. So that's a crazy number up there. So 2.2 kind of falls in line to where average sold price has been for a couple of weeks now. And we are 12% higher for townhouses average sold price versus last year's average sold price. Let's dive deep into the condo area here. So sales came down to 313 sales. So all of the city of Toronto with the thousands and thousands and thousands of condos, we sold only 313 condos, which is down from where we were over 500 condos a week being sold kind of middle to end of March. So sales have been going down. Looks like we've missed a peak over there. When it comes to average sold price has come down to just under 700,000. We're sitting at 693,000 for the average condo price. Now the amount of condos being purchased at $1 million or more has come down to 26, which is quite a bit lower from where it was the previous week at 38. And looking at price, I mean, since the beginning of the year, price has gone up, but it's been pretty stable right now when it comes to condo prices. Compared to last year, well, last year at this time for the same week ending, 23 were sold at $1 million or more. This year, 26, so it's pretty close, but we are 2% higher, only 2% higher than last year's average sold price. Compared to last year, well, we're selling less condos this time this year than we were last year, and 58% sold at list price or more. Listings are way down. We listed just under 600. 594 condos were listed last week. And months of inventory came up a little bit to 1.8 months of inventory. Still very low, very tight. It is very much still a seller's market. And when we look at the overall months of inventory broken down by all the different regions and the home types, hey, you know what? It's pretty low. The inventory is really tight. And normally when months of inventory are this low, in normal conditions, in a normal situation, normal economy, prices would be coming up. But it kind of begs the question, how much higher could they have gone? Could they go? It looks like we've missed the peak. It was middle to end of March when it came to the higher sales and the higher average sold prices. We've kind of come down a little bit. I'm not saying by any means the market has dropped. The fact that months of inventory is this slow, it's going to keep prices up. They're just not, it doesn't seem like they're going higher and higher right now. Maybe in another month or two, all that's going to change. But right now, prices seem pretty stable. We have kind of missed the top a little bit. And you just, you know, we can't be at a full run for about a year without taking a breath and just calming down a little bit. My name is Santos Sessa with Remax Premier. Let me know if you have any questions. Hope you enjoyed the show and take care.